Hi, welcome back. This is EC2 Hands On. In this lab, we're going to create EC2 instance from scratch, and we will see various components of EC2 instance and how we're going to connect to EC2 instance that we're going to create in this lab. For that, you need to log into AWS console and click on services. You can find EC2 under compute. Remember, EC2 is a compute offering from AWS. Click on EC2. You will be redirected to EC2 dashboard. In the dashboard, you can find some quick facts about currently running instances, snapshots, load balancers, security groups that we have created, and the key value pairs, which we are going to see that in a moment. So you can see some quick facts about your EC2 instance related data. The important point here is, if you read this text, you are using the following Amazon EC2 resources in US East region. EC2 is region specific. Unlike IAM, which is global, EC2 is region specific. To create any EC2 instance, click on Launch Instance. Remember, we have mentioned about Amazon machine images. To create any EC2 instance, we need AMIs. So these are the available AMIs from AWS, and you can also upload your own AMIs, and there are marketplace AMIs. So for this demo purpose, I'll be selecting Amazon Linux. Click on select. The first thing is to choose the instance type. Remember, there are different types of instances available for us. Based on the requirement, we can choose. So if you want to see the classification of different types, you can find it here in detailed classification. For general purpose, what are the model names available, and CPU, memory, storage, everything is available here in this link. Compute optimized, memory optimized, accelerated computing, and storage optimized. We have used a sentence to remember this five different categories using GoPro cams are very famous. For this demo, I'll choose a free tier eligible one, T2 Micro. Click on Configure Instance Details. Here in this step, we can configure EC2 instance. For example, we can specify number of instances that we can create. So in this example, we are creating only one. However, you can create multiple instances here itself. If we provide 10, it is going to create 10 instances of the same AMI. And also we can launch them into auto scaling group. If we launch these instances in auto scaling group, we can have some policies. Based on the these policies, we can automatically increase or decrease the number of instances. We can request for spot instances. We can create our VPC, virtual private cloud, subnet mask, auto assign default value for auto assign public IP address. We want to be able to connect to this instance, so we'll just leave it. Here there is an option for IAM role. We can also add IAM role to this instance. For example, I can create a new IAM role here or add existing IAM role. And this option is shutdown behavior. When you are shutting down this instance, what you want to do? Either you want to stop it or terminate. This is particularly helpful if you are doing a lab or a practice. So you can select terminate so that when you shut down, it will automatically delete it. Next step is storage. When it comes to storage, remember we have discussed about EBS, Elastic Block Store. In storage, we have two different types, SSD backed storages and HDD backed storages. And some are supported as a root volumes and some are not supported. Here we can see that this is a root volume and only SSD backed storages and magnetic disks are supported as root volumes. So you can see them here in the option. We don't see cold HDD here because that is not supported as a root volume. By default, we're going to be selecting general purpose SSD. But if you want high IOPS, you can select provisioned IOPS. And IOPS limit is 32,000. If I give 33,000, you can straight away see that it is throwing me an error saying that it has to be between 100 to 32,000. Also, I can select magnetic standard. So for this demo, I'm selecting general purpose SSD. Next important point is delete on termination flag. This is very important. When you select this flag, what happens is when you terminate EC2 instance, the EBS volume attached to it will be deleted as well. This is particularly helpful when you are doing practice and development test related scenarios. But whenever you are dealing with the production systems, it is better to uncheck this flag so that even you accidentally terminate your EC2 instance, you still have the backup of your EC2 instance EBS volume and you should be able to restore it from that backup. Next, click on tags. Here we can add tags. Tags are helpful to identify by name. For example, I can add a dev web server. Click on configure security group. Here we can configure our own DMZ zone and allow what are the IP addresses that can access this EC2 instance, or all the security related stuff can be handled here. So I'm leaving the defaults here. So it is allowed through SSH port 22. And now it is allowing all IP addresses. Click on next. And here we can see that the summary of all the details that we have created here. And it is actually telling you a warning that it is not secure. We know that already because we have allowed all the IP addresses here. So for this demo purpose, this should be fine. Click on launch. When we click on launch, we can see that it is asking for a key value pair, whether I can create one or if I already have, I can use that one. So for this, I'm going to create clouds demo key value pair. And we need to download this because while using this key value pair, we should be able to connect to our EC2 instance, launch instance. So it will take some time to launch this instance. So I'll pause the video and come back once this is done.